On 28th March, Prime Minister Narendra Modi announced the setting up of the PM CARES Fund. It aims to help those in distress due to corona pandemic. Donations poured in from every quarter. But do we, as citizens of this country, know how much money PM CARES has received? The answer is no. An India Spend report published on 20th of May puts the figure as ₹9,677 crores based on figures mentioned in the government press releases. But there is no official confirmation of this figure. Also, do we know how these funds have been utilized so far? Again, the answer is no. So let's ask again, why shouldn't the PM CARES Fund come under the Right to Information or RTI? Several RTI queries have been denied, claiming that the PM CARES is a public charitable trust and not a public authority. Okay, so first let's look at the definition of public authority under the RTI Act. And I quote, any authority or body or institution of self-government established or constituted by notification issued or order made by the appropriate government, unquote. Given this definition, there isn't one but five reasons to show that PM CARES is a public authority and is liable to share information under RTI. Reason number one, PM CARES was set up by the government. How do we say this? Well, firstly, the setting up of the PM CARES was notified to the public on 28th of March by the Ministry of Corporate Affairs, saying, and I quote, the Government of India has set up the Prime Minister's Citizen Assistance and Relief in Emergency Situations Fund, unquote, which means the Government of India has control over it. Secondly, the office of the PM CARES Fund is in the Prime Minister's office in Delhi. Third, just like the PM is the chairperson of the Prime Minister's National Relief Fund or PMNRF, the Prime Minister is the chairperson of the PM CARES Fund as well. In 2007, the then Chief Information Commissioner, Wajahat Habibullah, passed an interesting order about the Prime Minister's National Relief Fund. He said, since PMNRF information is held by the PMO as a public authority, they are obliged to share it with the citizens under the RTI Act. Going by same logic, PM CARES should also come under RTI since it is also controlled by the Prime Minister's office. Reason number two, use of government machinery to promote PM CARES. On the 30th March, PM Modi, at a video conference with the heads of the Indian missions across the world, advised them to publicize the new PM CARES Fund to mobilize foreign donations. The question is, can government officials and government missionaries be used to publicize PM CARES if it is only a charitable trust? Take a look at what transparency activist, retired Commodore Lokesh Batra found out from the Indian High Commission in Singapore, that the Singapore government refused to allow official channels to promote PM CARES as it is called itself a charitable trust. While the Indian Embassy in Moscow told Batra in an RTI reply that PM CARES was given publicity on the embassy's website and social media pages. Would any other charitable trust ever get publicity on any Indian Embassy website? Of course not. Reason number three, usage of gov.in in its domain name. PMCARES.gov.in is the website address of the PM CARES Fund. But government guidelines say a gov.in domain name can be allotted to six categories of offices or public authorities. Apex offices like the President of India or the Prime Minister's office, government ministries or departments, state and union territory offices, India's parliament, judicial bodies and all other legislative bodies and government institutions. So how did PM CARES manage to get a gov.in domain name when it does not fall under any of these categories? Reason number four, tax exemption relief to PM CARES donations. On 31st March, just 2 days after PM CARES was announced, a government ordinance amended provisions of the Income Tax Act. As a result, a donation made to the PM CARES Fund would be eligible for 100% tax deduction. This was clear use of government machinery to promote PM CARES. Reason number 5. PM CARES is eligible for CSR funds. Just a day after the launch of PM CARES, the Ministry of Corporate Affairs issued a notification saying, and I quote, "Any contribution made by a company to the PM CARES Fund shall qualify as corporate social responsibility or CSR," unquote. After that, several public sector units or PSUs did donate huge amounts to PM CARES. For instance, Power Finance Corporation donated Rs 200 crore. Multiple public sector banks and enterprises under the Finance Ministry together donated over 200 crores as CSR funds to PM CARES. Now we know PSUs come under RTI and are liable to share information under RTI. In that case, why not PM CARES? Former Chief Information Commissioner Wajahat Habibullah even told The Quint, and I quote, "Whether PM CARES come under RTI or not, any contribution to PM CARES by PSUs does come under the RTI," unquote. The fact is, several ministries and government departments have contributed to PM CARES. The Ministry of Defence contributed one day salary of all its employees, roughly Rs 500 crores. Steel PSUs also contributed 500 crores. This is public money, all of it. But since PM CARES is not answerable under RTI, there is zero transparency and no one will ever know how much public money was donated and how it was utilized. Is this fair? Clearly no. So, can someone answer this question? Why is the PM CARES Fund shrouded in secrecy?